students, I like them to use this. This is the traditional Spanish style building. Because if you have an adjustable mold like that, then they can build this themselves. It's a lot, it's really easy. And they can use this for different sized instruments. With this, you have to make a dedicated mold for each size you're doing. And it's good. I mean, if you're doing production work or anything, you know, I think this is probably a good way to go. And you do get more precision results and symmetry.
My first side bender, I can really get it dialed in pretty clean, so it's kind of nice. Yeah. And then the neck, you know, we go through the full process with the neck, of just building that. That, with the students, we have a, this one happens to be, this one, I cut that off. Well, it's actually a block here. It's a solid block, it's not stacked. As you can see, it follows the grain there. So when you look up to the side, my car, this is going to look like it's one piece. And, but I like using, rather than cutting it from a big, thick chunk of wood, it's actually better to do it this way. So this is the neck portion. It comes like this. We have a jig that's 15 degrees. We cut this 15 degrees on the bandsaw. We take this, we put the two pieces together. I have them clamp it, get a block clamp, screw up that surface, and then this becomes a spark joint that comes on here and attaches like that. So now we've got that 15 degree angle. So the beauty of this is a solid piece of wood. The grain would be running off here with a short grain. You see a lot of old Martin guitars that break right there, so they just snap. So by doing this, you end up, this spark joint is very strong. If you hand plane it real clean, you're gonna get a real strong joint. It's gonna be stronger than the wood itself. So it's not gonna break. So once that's screwed up, then the blocks go on like this. And so once it's screwed up, we have this here. And then, so the students get it like this. They do all the handwork, they put it together. Then what we do is we drill for all our jointers. So we drill a 10 millimeter hole here. And we also drill, put a barrel nut in there. So this is how we join it to the body. So then what we do is we drill a hole here. So we work off center lines all the time. It's very important. So once this goes in, that gets set. So that has a hole drilled in. So this head block is about an inch wide, about an inch thick and 2 inches wide. It supports the fingerboard, I think, also. So it kind of beefs everything up. And then the same with the tail. Tail piece, hard one is getting this in
there. Are they all buttered up, or do you do any piece lock?
There's a hole that's drilled through there, so it's a butt joint, and it's very strong. Actually, it's a really strong joint. On a guitar, I use it for racking, but on this, because it's such a small instrument, the ukulele, the one bolt was the way to go with it. The problem, and then when the fingerboard is attached, the fingerboard gets glued down. It prevents it from cracking. But this is just mechanically sucks it together and pulls it in place. So it's very strong,
but it allows.
It's nice because Taylor Guitar, did this bolt-on method. They came up with this, so it makes for a removable joint. So all I have to do, if I ever want a guitar, especially the neck will start pulling up, and if I have to reset the neck, it's very easy to take it off. All I do is I heat this up with an iron, like a slight dental floss under there, a real nice spatula, break it. I use what's called Titan 1, which has a low release point, so just for that reason. So I can pop this up, unbolt that, I can take the neck off. Now I can reset this angle. I can tilt it back down. The nice thing about this too is before I glue this down, really what's important is the relationship of this neck to the wood. And what we do is, I have a little shim. What I do is I have a saddle height. Often